You know, in Texas, Salvinia probably only 15 years. Since 1998, was the first discovery in Houston area.
As a an ornamental plant, somebody put it in their pond or something, and then after a flood or something, or it just got tracked into waterways, and it's just spread from there.
Right now, almost in most water bodies in East Texas or South Texas, and is it become worse and worse. And a few years ago, it's hard to believe this species is getting this far, because we think it's a tropical species. Actually, the plant can survive in cold weather. Even this year's cold weather down to 15 degrees, the plant is still able to survive.
It doesn't seem to have a true dormancy. It does slow down in the winter, and a lot of what you're seeing where it's brown, it looks dead, it's not quite dead, and in the spring there is enough of it left that it will come back, and it will come back quickly.
There seems to be nothing as of yet that can rid the system of this nasty plant. The plant always comes back. It has for the last several years, even through drought and hard winters. This fern is very prolific, grows exponentially. As a result, it outcompetes native plants that are beneficial for wildlife and fish, essentially reduce oxygen concentrations in water. Ultimately, when the plant does die, reduce oxygen levels even further, so it can lead to fish kills.
So we lose the water, we lose the ecology for the fish and the other, you know, the recreation.
The giant Salvinia is a floating fern originally from South America. It doesn't have viable spores or seeds. What it does is it grows vegetatively, and under optimum conditions, a mat of it can double in size in under a week.
But we have warm, hot summers, we have a long growing season, and we have large bodies of water in East Texas. This plant does really well in areas with more or less calm or still water, backwater areas with not much water movement.
We've even seen examples where Salvinia has not only invaded and taken over the water body, but now there's grass growing on top of the Salvinia. So what you're seeing is a total change from water to a different environment.